Behind today's global capital markets stand millions of retirement savers who are using funds in the capital markets to meet their savings goals. What do we know about them and their needs both at the end of their career and at the beginning? I gained some insight at ICI's recent collaborative discussion at Chatham House.
Probably 80% of global financial assets are going to be used in some way for household retirement security in the end. So it is really the core of, at the heart of the capital markets. I would say that there's been this 20-year evolution we're very familiar with of defined contribution systems around the world in a variety of countries, including the United Kingdom, where we are today. And now there's this focus on the deaccumulation phase and how people are behaving, what makes it unique and different, and some of the interesting challenges of thinking about simultaneously your money and your health.
Interesting. And so, William, from your perspective, you look after things in the UK, look at a lot of the data that's coming out of pension savings in the UK, and you're following the impact of some of the various tweaks and reforms that have been made here in this system over the past few years. What do you see?
So auto-enrollment was introduced here in 2012, and it would be fair to say that it's been staggeringly successful. The opt-out rates of individuals who have never saved before, never saved for retirement, is extremely low and actually has settled down to an ongoing figure of around about 6%. The challenge, however, for us as an industry is to recognize that these are individuals that have never saved before. So we now have individuals accumulating invested wealth that the industry has never interacted with, and it raises a challenge for us to think about how we best help those individuals plan for retirement when they have now accumulated DC assets alongside other pension assets, potentially, or certainly alongside Social Security benefits.
One of the other surprises that you shared with me, William, about the UK research you've done so far, and this is again perhaps backing up to that younger saver, the younger investor, is that not only does auto-enrollment work, but then returning to that question of auto-enrollment 3 years later works again in capturing people who even did proactively opt out the first time.
Absolutely right. So the legislation created a framework to take individuals who did opt out and re-enroll them again 3 years later. And when we looked at the data, bearing in mind that 100% of that group of individuals had opted out the first time, when they were then re-enrolled again, only 13% opted out a second time. So the power of automated features is really being emphasized by the UK experience.
And Steve, your global data has looked after investors who've been in a pool like this a long, long time and can see what they're doing. What are some of the things that Vanguard's suggesting in terms of behavioral economics for the older saver, the pensioner?
On the post-retirement phase, it's interestingly enough it's going to be a challenge to get people to spend their money, because the real fear for a lot of individuals is not simply, say, running out of money, but needing money for aged care costs and our long-term care costs. And so helping people better spend down wisely and more optimally undertake that spending is really a challenge that faces the industry in the years ahead.